What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkPad X1 Extreme Generation 5 laptop. So what comes inside the box? So we have your ThinkPad Smart Feature pamphlet. Cool. You have your safety information pamphlet right here. You have your Windows 11 Pro Recovery Media Entitlement. And we have the ThinkPad X1 Extreme Gen 5 Setup Guide. Cool. It goes over some of the ports and features, which we are going to go over that pretty soon. You have your heavy gauge power cable and your 230-watt power adapter. Now, I'm going to take the power adapter and the power cable, and I'm going to hook it up real quick. And last but not least, we have the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 Extreme Generation 5 sporting a carbon fiber weave top, which is beautiful, or black, awesome, weighing around 4.2 pounds with a thickness of 0.79 inches. Now, for ports and features, if you have the laptop facing you to the point that you are able to open it up like this, on your right-hand side, you have one SD card reader, you have two 3.2 USB ports, and this one right here is always on charging. On the left-hand side, you have your combo audio jack, an HDMI port, and then two Type-C Thunderbolt 4 ports. And then last but not least, your power port. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on the X1 Extreme Generation 5 ThinkPad. We are going to hook up the power. Awesome. We're going to open up this beautiful laptop. Look at that beautiful 16-inch display, which we are going to go over pretty soon. Power button is located right here on the right side at the top. We're going to power this guy on. Now on the X1 Extreme, there's different ways to log in. Right now it's looking for my face to log in, or you could use the fingerprint scanner, which is actually located and integrated within the power button. And I'm actually going to log in with my finger. So let's just place it there. Bam. Again, you are able to use Windows Hello to log into this machine with no problem. All right, so let's talk about the trackpad on the X1 Extreme Gen 5. Now the trackpad itself, it just basically works. I didn't have any issues at all. I did find myself using a USB mouse the majority of the time. If you want to know the measurement of the trackpad, it is around 4.56 inches. For the keyboard on the X1 Extreme is really responsive. I do enjoy using the keyboard on these particular ThinkPads because they just work. The key distance between them is 0.12 inches. It is backlit with two settings. I don't see that the backlit is too bright, but it is there for you to use. As always, the ThinkPads have that track point signature red dot right there. It gives you an option to use it if you're not too comfortable with the trackpad, but I'm not really comfortable using that track point as well. And that's why I always go into using the USB mouse. The X1 Extreme Gen 5 speakers are located on your right and left side of the keyboard. They're pretty loud. The highest that I got was around 86.5 decibels. Now for this display, the display is 16 inches IPS anti-glare, non-touch. They do have the touchscreen model, which I'm kind of happy that Lenovo actually sent me the non-touch one because I don't like touchscreen laptops at all. Resolution on this guy is around 3840 by 2400. The brightness level right now, this is the highest on the brightness level, and this is the lowest that you could get on this particular laptop. And this is the highest, and this is the lowest, and this is the highest. Now, if you want to know the nit level, it is around 600. It is HDR enabled, which is awesome. Just make sure that you plug in the power before you turn on your HDR within the Windows settings. At the top of the display, you have a 1080p webcam with the privacy guard, which is, again, you got to make sure you just dig in there to open it up. And on the left and right hand side of the webcam, you have your dual mics. All right, right now, I'm going to show you guys raw footage of me using the webcam and the built-in mic using OBS Studio. So let's take a look at that.
Whoa, yes. So this is the webcam and also the built-in mic on the ThinkPad X1 Extreme that I'm reviewing for you guys. This is raw footage. I'm not going to modify the audio, as well as I'm not going to make any cuts on the video in case I make any mistakes. But this is how it looks and feels. I think when I do post editing, I'm going to actually see how it actually looks. But I am doing 1080p, 60 frames per second, using OBS Studio's basic settings, and this is how it looks and feels. It looks like the webcam and the audio might be good for Zooming and teaming and doing all types of meetings with your colleagues, as well as streaming. So this is how it feels and looks with the X1 Extreme.
All right, so let's go over some of the specifications on the X1 Extreme Generation 5 from Lenovo. Now, this laptop was sent to me with these particular settings, but you are able to configure it at the Lenovo site, and the price range is going to go up depending on what you get. We will go over the price range pretty soon, so don't worry. So I'm going to hold down the Control key, Shift, and Escape to open up the Task Manager. I am going to expand this up a little bit. Let's go into Performance. Let's right-click on the CPU, change graph to Logical Processor, and this guy is running a 12th gen Intel Core i7-12700H processor with a base speed clock of 2.30 gigahertz, 14 cores, 20 logical processors. Holy crap, it has virtualization enabled if you are playing around with VMware Workstation or VirtualBox or Hyper-V, you're able to do it on this particular machine. Awesome. Now for memory, it is housing 16 gigs, and I think the max for memory is around 32 gigs or 64 gigs, I'm not too sure. For hard drive space, it is running a solid state drive, which is around 512 gigs. And for graphics, the first graphics, it comes with the CPU, which is the Intel Iris Xe graphics card. And then you have a discrete graphics card, which is the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 360, which is a beast. Wow, this is beautiful. 6 gigs, dedicated GPU memory, 6 gigs. So that's the size of this graphics cards, which actually allowed me to do some gaming. I was able to play Fortnite with no problem on this machine. So no lag at all. When I was using it for video editing and doing a little bit of Photoshop and using Media Encoder to render out some 4K videos, I didn't have any issues on this particular machine. I actually used Puget Systems Benchmark Premiere and Photoshop on this machine, and it gave it pretty good scores. I was really happy with the results on this particular machine. Now for heating, I did notice heating around this area, and it's because right between the display and the keyboard, you have the vent, and that vent is basically just pushing all that hot air to the display. I got an average of between 93 to 103 degrees of heat around this area, which is not that bad. But the fan noise, I did hear the fan noise really heavy when I was like starting up Fortnite, or I was starting up any particular game or rendering. You did hear the fan noise really loud around this area right here. It's between the display and the keyboard. All right, so we just went over some of the specifications on the X1 Extreme Generation 5. So let's talk about the battery. So I'm going to minimize this. I'm going to open up this guy right here. And I love using PCMark to run benchmark on the battery life. I've used this new software that PCMark released not too long ago. And I ran it 5 times. And the first test, it lasts for around 4 hours and 46 minutes. On the second test, it caught me off guard because it gave me an additional hour of battery life, which lasts around 5 hours and 42 minutes. On the third test, 7 hours and 34 minutes. So I bumped up 2 more hours. On the fourth test, 8 hours. And on the last test, I got 8 hours, which is kind of matching what the fourth test gave me, but it just reduced by 1 minute, which was good. So I said to myself, okay, to average it out between 4 and 5, I would say about 8 hours using a benchmark software. But using the machine every day without plugging it up, I got 7.5 hours of battery life. And that's me basically watching videos, editing with Premiere, rendering out, using it for Photoshop, going online, doing some research and stuff like that. All right, so let's conclude our unboxing slash review on Lenovo's ThinkPad Extreme X1 Generation 5 laptop. Now, off the back, I don't know if you guys can see it on the video, but there's a lot of, you know, fingerprint around the keyboard. That drives me nuts. It does attract a lot of smudges and, you know, fingerprints on this particular machine. For external monitors, I was able to hook up a native HDMI small little external monitor. And for the Type-C ports that you have here, Thunderbolt 4, you are able to use native Type-C monitors. I didn't have that, so I had to actually use a Type-C adapter and just take advantage of the HDMI port on that Type-C adapter. But again, you are able to hook up, you know, 3 external monitors on this machine. Just make sure you plug in the power to support that many monitors. Now for pricing, the retail starting price is around $1,650, and it all depends on how you get it, because you are able to configure the monitor and you are able to configure different graphics card models, as well as bump up the memory and also increase the storage capacity on the X1 Extreme Gen 5 at the Lenovo site. Now, overall experience, I did enjoy using this machine with editing Premiere, Photoshop, surfing the net, watching YouTube videos, and going to Netflix and all that stuff on this machine. It's a great machine. It's a powerful machine. When I was rendering out and I was playing games, it caught me off guard. That huge noise fan came out of nowhere, and it's going to be consistent. It's just going to be there. So keep in mind that that noise is going to be there every time you do something heavy on this particular machine. Now for the size, weighing around 4.2 pounds and the thickness of 0.79 inches is not that bad. I don't feel like it's a heavy laptop to travel around with. Overall, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.